Friday block party. It's going to kick off this Friday, like I said, at the radio station at 5 o'clock.
You know what else we're giving away?
What?
We're giving away tickets to Kiki Sheard.
Yes.
At our first Friday block party. So if you show up, then you'll get a chance to enter your name into the drawing to possibly win some last-minute tickets to see her perform this Saturday.
Okay.
Normally, she be singing, boy, too. She be singing.
She be singing. It's mm-hmm. your girl.
Mm-hmm. Sports Priest is going to call us on the hotline here in just a couple of seconds. So we have a little bit of difficulty. So Sports Preacher, call me on the hotline. We'll get you on here in just a few minutes. That's right. Just Brittany and Alphonse Arterwin this Friday at the our first Friday party. And I'm looking forward to that. Yes. Okay. Let me see here. Is this the Sports Preacher?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, home team.
We're here. Good morning. Yes,
sir.
All right, man. Talk to us. What's going on in the world of sports this morning, man?
Man, did you see that Rocket versus the Spurs game last night? You know, I was already talking about my boy LeBron blowing out the Raptors, but after seeing the Rockets up by 37 points at one point in that game against the Spurs last night, I could not believe what I was seeing. They came out and just shot the Spurs out of the gym. They went 22 of 50 from three-point line, and if you take away some bad shots that were taken by the bench once they put in the game, they were really way more active than that. They were probably closer to 50% from three-point line last night. James Harden played out of his mind. Tony Parker looked slow. Kawhi Leonard looked like he was trying to do it all by himself. I mean, it was just, I've never seen the Spurs coach team look so bad against the Rockets. Now, I have seen them look like that against Miami when they won a championship, when they had Tim Duncan and Ginobili and the whole nine, and then they, you know, they were able to bounce back because they pulled the guys. But last night, it just seemed to be a little bit different. There's no Tim Duncan coming through that door. There's, Ginobili and Tony Parker are both older now, and so I don't know if the Spurs have an answer in this series if the Rockets continue to play like they played last night.
All right. Well, we hope it goes at least six games. We at least can ask for that.
Well, I mean, Tony, I don't know, brother. I mean, they won by 27. I don't know if it's going to. This may go five. If the Spurs don't answer in game two, it might be a wrap.
All right.
It might be a wrap.
All right. All right, Sports Preacher, we'll check back in with you after 7 o'clock, man. All right?
All right, bro.
Sounds good. All right, y'all. It's 6:58. Let me pick out another song that my coworkers never heard of. They were a little bit too young. This is the Queen of Soul. You might have heard of her, Zach. She goes by the name of Aretha Franklin.
Oh, I know Aretha.
And this is something that I steady do. I'm rocking steady this morning. That's the name of this, Zach.
Okay. Rock steady. Got you. I'm feeling it. My shoulders is moving.
Here we go.